everybody, we're here at Microsoft Inspire, and I'm going to show you our upcoming ezeep for Windows Virtual Desktop service. And I just have a little demo prepared, so let's have a look. So first, the ezeep for Windows Virtual Desktop will be in the Microsoft Marketplace, in the Azure Marketplace. And we have this here already. All you gotta do is sign in with your Azure credentials as an administrator for your organization and click on Get It Now. You allow Microsoft to share some of your information with us and just continue. Now, we're getting this information from Microsoft and simply process that in our form. So we're logging in here again to authenticate on our end. And the next we see is our place here. So just logging in with my email address. There we go. And fill out the information that we need to actually then have you in our system. Inc. Industry is technology, country United States, zip code 80205, and we are in Denver in Colorado. And just click on create account, and then within a few seconds in the backend, an account will be created and you're ready to use this service. And here you see what permissions we need. We can read your users and some information about your groups. Just accept that. And when this process is done, the organization is created, you will end up in the ezeep portal. And this is your admin portal. You're already there. And you're starting with the quick start guide that really gives you a very simple way of understanding what you need to do next. Just read through this, look at the graphic. What we're going to do here is we have the Windows Virtual Desktop here on the left side where we have the ezeep print app installed. That's where the user actually hits the print button. And on the other side, we either have a small appliance called the ezeep hub, or we got the piece of software installed on the PC or Mac or the print server, for example. And the ezeep cloud brings these two pieces together. And this admin portal we see here is basically the part where you configure how you want this printing to work. And I'm not going into detail about this. Yeah, you can just click through this yourself, get your idea what you need to do, how you configure it. When the ezeep app and the ezeep, simply go to local printer support and decide which group should be allowed to print to the local configured printer. Now, this could be a printer that is at a home office on a PC, or it could be in a small office where people have individual printers, and they're not the network printers, which you wanted to manage a little bit more central. So all you gotta do here is select the group. We're reading these groups directly out from the Azure directory, so there's no user management, no group management. You have to do in two places. It's all done in Azure directory. And you see the group is here, and from this point on, everybody within that group can print to their local printers. Now, if you feel that is a security issue, we don't want to do that for anybody, then just turn it off, and nobody will be able to print to their local printer. That's how simple this is. Now, for printers that you manage more in a centralized way, network printers, printers on a print server, or printers that you connect with that ezeep hub, we got this tab here called Network Printers. And basically, all these endpoints, these connectors, report back the printers they have, or they manage, and you as the administrator can simply select one or multiple printers here and make changes to the name so they're easier to recognize and the users will see that name in their session, in their virtual desktop. You can change the location. And you can set the assignment where you basically say, well, these printers should only be available to these user groups. Again, Azure directory group. Or you can set IP ranges where you say, well, only if you're from within this range, you are actually allowed to see that printer. And that is an additive component. So you have to be in that user group and you have to be within that IP range. So really simple. If you got lots of printers, we put a little bit of effort into that. If you got lots of printers, you can use these filters and say, only show me the printers that are currently offline. Or you can say, only show me the printers that are currently in Berlin. Then you see these printers here. So it's really nice and easy way to do that. If you want to know a little bit about where these printers are actually coming from, you can go to connectors and simply select the connector that you want to look at. So we got one here in the Denver office. There's an ezeep hub. This is the hub. This is the IP address. It's currently online. So you got some information about it. And what's really helpful is you can simply jump back to show me all the connectors that are connected on this hub. So again, it becomes very easy to manage a large amount of printers through this interface. And without having any real user or group management, it's very easy to manage all your users just by using Azure Directory. Now, this is enough about the portal. Let's actually look on a Windows Virtual Desktop. Let me jump to one, there we go. So this is a Windows Virtual Desktop that we set up for this demo. It has our ezeep agent installed. So the printers that I have currently installed on my local computer here are already mapped into this computer here. So if I just open a document like this one here, and I go to the print option as a user, I don't have to learn anything new. It's exactly the same as it was before. I see my printer name. That's the same name as I have on my local machine. I can go to the properties and then select the paper format or the quality of the printout. I can even select advanced finishing option with this driver. And it's always the same user interface. So we have a universal driver always showing the same user interface, but adjusting the content of these options based on the properties the printer actually supports. So I'm going to do that, and I'm just printing one page here, so you see how fast that is. Just hit print. Now the job is being prepared in a universal format. It is compressed, it's encrypted, it's sent through our cloud back to my PC here, to that local connector, and then from there it goes to the printer. And that just takes a couple of seconds based on your internet speed. There it is. So it's a really fast and easy way to print while your users are working in the cloud on virtual desktops or Windows virtual desktops, where you have little administration, a lot of automation, and we as ezeep take care of the actual management of these servers, of the actual printing that happens in the servers. This is the initial demo here. We will add more features in the future. Cloud rendering is one of them. Follow me printing, monitoring, tracking, these kind of things will all be added to this platform in the upcoming months. Thank you.